Okay, welcome to the Chase Iskraft webinar in January 2021, the third webinar in this series. And as promised, I will show you today the highlights of the new release of the 1.20 release, and which was released on Monday. And when I prepared the webinar for today, I found a couple of errors, so I released a new version 1.2.1 just a couple of hours ago. So let's look at the script for today. You can find it on the webpage, the Chase Iskraft webpage, under docs, and there you will find the PDF. Maybe I will make some changes after the webinar, but for now it's downloadable. And we had some problems to produce the video from the last webinar, but now it's online. So, in the last one question in the last webinar was a non-standard scaling of access, namely you want labels not by 1, 2, 3, but by multiples of pi, and I updated the script for volume 2. And you can see it here. The trick is you have to change the tick attribute, the ticks attribute, and give a scale number. In this case, it's math.py. And then you have to supply, or you should supply, a scale symbol. And this is a little bit tricky. This is the UTF-16 code for Pi. You will find it on any Unicode table. So instead of the HTML entity, you have to take this syntax with a backslash and U. And then it looks like this. And here in the bottom, you will see, you see the multiples of pi in the x scale. Okay, this was an update from last time, my homework, so to say. And now we start with Chase Iskraft in version 1.2. First, I want to know, want to announce that we will, from now on, we will follow a different update cycle or release cycle. We will quite frequently release patch releases, which are notified in the third number of the version number. So one example is today we released already 1.2.1. Okay, then I want to highlight a few of the new features. The first feature I want to announce is there are new attributes for board, new attributes for the board. And I show it to you in the Fiddle. So you give title, you can give a title and a description. And then, I will show it here. And then, Chase Iskraft will add a new division with an ID which consists of the ID of the board and then ARIA label and ARIA description. And these two diffs, which are not visible, are used in attributes for the construction for the board, namely the tag, the attributes ARIA labeled by and ARIA described by. So this is the way that visually impaired people can use their reader to, or blind people can use their special reader to get some information out of the construction. Okay, so this is not visible in the browser. Okay, then there are several new board attributes. Most of them were suggested by the people from GlassCalc, and they are quite useful. So let's look at this fiddle. The first one is the first one is drag. So you may know that there are attributes like zoom or pan, and now there's a new attribute named called drag, and you can set it to enabled false, and then no element in the board can be dragged. This may be useful for some purposes, and you don't have to set all elements to fixed equal to true. And the next one is show info box. You may know that show info box is an attribute of an element. So if there's an show info box equal to true, which was the default before, then as soon as the mouse pointer hovers over the point, then you see the coordinates of the point. Yes, I want to drag it around, so I can turn on dragging again by setting board attributes drag enabled equal to true. So, sorry. And now I can drag again. And you see the info box changes. So I can turn it off. The show info box false. Then you don't see it. And I can set it to the string value inherit. Then it inherits the value given in the board. And this is the default now. So the default value is show info box true for the board, and all elements have an inherit, have show info box inherit. Sorry. Oh. Okay, then the next attribute I want to mention is the attribute max frame rate. So you might have a very complicated construction which takes a lot of time for each update on a smartphone, for example, and then you want to restrict the number reduce the number of updates. So this is the max frame rate for, and you can set it, for example, to some value. The default value is 40, and you can set it to a value, for example, 10. Then there are only 10 updates possible per second. So each update has to be 100 milliseconds. So this is not that bad. I don't know. Yeah, then it's not very good. But at least it doesn't stop. Maybe for 20. 20 is okay again. So you ensure that there are not too many updates, which also saves battery on smartphones. So, okay, this is these are these three attributes: drag, show info box, and max frame rate. And then the next one is a very nice new attribute contributed by the people from GlassCalc. It's called beautiful scientific tick labels, and this comes into play if you have a very large scale of your construction. Let's have an example. So here, the bounding box is 50,000 in each direction. And if you say, if you set the ticks attribute, beautiful scientific tick labels to true, then you see these nice dots and explanations. And I set it to false to see the contrast. So much, it's ugly. Then this is not new. But I didn't mention it yet. Access have the attribute scalable, and if you set this to true, I set it for X and for Y. Yeah. Then the first tick. The first major tick label, the first major tick is highlighted. If you hover over it, and you can drag it, and you can scale the construction by dragging. You can scale it vertically by dragging this tick. The same is true for the X coordinate. Okay, this might be useful in some contexts, but of course you must notify your users that they can do this. Then the next new feature is the sensitivity of the construction. In JSXGraph, we have an attribute which is hard to find. I know, it's very hard to find. an attribute called precision, a global attribute, where you can set the precision of the various user devices. So, for example, here we are. The upper blue line is completely standard. So here I have a mouse, Apple mouse. So the pointer device is a mouse, and the line will be highlighted only if I'm very close to the line. Or I can drag it if I'm very close. I can drag it as soon as the line is highlighted. Okay, then I can drag it. And these values, touch, mouse, and pen, are used to set different values for different devices, input devices. For example, for a touch device, if you use your finger, then you need much less precision than for a mouse or a pen. So, okay. And now, so what you already could do was to set this globally, to set JXG options precision before starting the construction. Then this was globally set for all elements. And then now with the new version, you can fine tune these settings for individual elements. So for example, line two, for line two, the precision is set to 100 pixel for all three input devices. So here I have to be very close to the first line, to the line, to the bottom line. It will be highlighted if I'm quite far away. So 100 pixel far away. The distance is still 100 pixel. Okay. So these were the most important new, or pretty much all new attributes which were added in the new release. And then a dream came true for me, namely I ported MetaPost curves to JSXGraph. You may know the name of Donald Knuth. He's the creator of the typesetting system tech, and he's the author of The Art of Computer Programming. Incidentally, there are two, at least two famous Donalds, namely the other one who is leaving today. He also wrote a book starting with The Art Of, but of course this one is much better. And in addition to this typesetting system tech, there's a system called MetaFont where Donald Knuth created his fonts. And this was later ported into MetaPost to create PostScript graphics. And both systems, MetaFont and MetaPost, they contain an algorithm by a PhD student of Don Knuth, which produces good looking Bézier curves. So what are Bézier curves? Of course, we have Bézier curves in JavaScript. These are Bézier curves. So the minimal Bézier curves consists of 4 points. A, B, C, and D. And so the curve will go through the first and the last point, and it will be controlled, the bending of the curve will be controlled by the control points B and C. And you can, in this way, you can create beautifully curved, paths. But as you see, it's not particularly easy to set these control points so that a good looking curve will result. It's you have to, in most cases, you have to try it out. It's a visual process, to an interactive process, to set these control points. And this is addressed by this algorithm of John Hoppe. Namely, for this algorithm, the input of this algorithm are just the red points, the interpolation points, and the algorithm will compute control points such that the resulting Bézier curve looks nice, whatever looks nice is. And just for the curious ones, Bézier curves are polynomial curves though of degree 3, so they are degree 3 curves. And you find a lot of some literature on it on the internet, and this Hoppe algorithm is, for example, implemented also in the Pages software by Apple. So, and here's an example how to use it in JSX graph. Well, and this is already too complicated. I will show you the example. Please forget these controls. What happens? So I have three sliders where you can dynamically change the style of this path. We will do it later, but for the moment, we have just four points, the red points, A, B, C, and D. And we set the controls to nothing. Okay, then the resulting curve will look like this. So this is also Bézier curve through these four points. And it will be the optimal curve according to the optimization or smooth or op according to some criteria, what's good looking. Okay. But in many cases, this is not enough because you want to have some restriction on these curves. And for this, we have these controls. And for example, we have we can set a direction, and here it is set for the direction is set for point one. So we start numbering by zero, though it's point B who is restricted in the direction, and the direction is some angle. So we can change this to, for example, 90, roughly 90. And then there's the constraint that a path through B has to be a vertical path. You can also, there are much more possibilities. For example, you can have two different directions for the ingoing path, ingoing path and the outgoing path, but I don't want to be too, go too much into details. Then you can set the tension, and the tension is how much is a parameter, how much bending you want. So the most important thing is if it's a very large value, like 20, then the points are connected by a straight line. And then there's a third parameter called curl, which also has a some influence. Okay. Yeah, this is a meta post, and I hope you find it useful to construct your so you don't have to set your Bézier points if you need it. Then we used this to create these meta post curves. We used it to create new arrow heads. Let's look at this example. So these are the arrow heads of Chase X graph. The these three ones below the x-axis are we had it before version 1.2. And now there's type 4, type 5, and type 6. So they are much smoother bent, and you might find them more beautiful. And these are defined by Bézier curves, which were computed by the hobby algorithm. I can show you how you can do it. Oh, we did it. So you can use, so if you want to have a new arrow type, then you can set it here and send us the Bézier curves. So here you can change everything of this arrow head, the curveness. And so we have the wing curve, this is this, and the tail curve, which affects this bending, and so on. Okay, though there are many upcoming possibilities. Yeah, these are arrowheads and metapost. And in the new version, we also made great progress with clipping. I will tell you something in one of the next webinars about clipping. Here's just the new RPDocs. So you can intersect. This is the difference. You can compute the difference of two paths, two closed paths. These could be polygons or curves or circles, or the intersection, or the union. And you see this works also for combination of path of curves and circles, for example. Yeah, and then next feature, now comes the experimental stuff. In the new version, we have a part of interval arithmetics. So what is this? It's Probably it's just for internal. I don't know if you can use it externally. And unfortunately, I couldn't manage to do the RP documentation. This will come in the next version, the documentation. So let's look at this example. You can use interval arithmetics by using JXG math interval arithmetic, and I use the shortcut I. Yep. Okay, then I can, is it possible to do something? No, okay. So you can set an interval I1 to be the number one. The next one is 2. So interval arithmetics has been developed to control the errors in numerical computing. There's a small error after 12 digits, and this error will be amplified by if you do a lot of calculations. But we will need it for plotting in a slightly different setting. Maybe I redo this now. I will first print the value of I1. So it's 1, 1. And then I will add 1 and 2. And you see the result is something between 2.9999 and 3. Something. And you see there's already some error. And but you cannot only set it to a simple value, but you can set every interval you can set the upper and lower bound, like here, to -1 and 2. Let's print I1. So I1 is 1, 2. And now I can print the logarithm of I1 and print it. Yes, and then it says the result of applying the logarithm to this interval has lower bound minus infinity and upper bound 0.69. Okay, so for functions, it's more or less a lookup for critical values. And and this is what we need for function plotting. So now I spent a lot of time in the last month to implement a better function plotter for Chase Iskraf. And there are some new attributes. So first, if you use let's start with an example. It contains many, many, many functions. We can set as attribute the plot version And the default value is 2. This is the old trusted plotting algorithm of JSX graph, which we had since many years. There's an older one, which you can access with plot version 1, but I don't recommend it. And so version 2 was used at least from 0.99 up to 1.1 and beyond. Version 3 is an unsuccessful trial of a new algorithm. And then there's number 4, plot version number 4, which will hopefully be the future. And so let's see an example. So this is power function x to the 2/3, and this is plotted with version 2, and now I switch it globally to version 4, and then you don't see any you don't see any changes. This is what I want to show you. So we have another. You might say that negative values of x for this function should be plotted, but math.pow of JavaScript doesn't do this. So we introduced rational power. So you have to give the numerator and the denominator, and then it plots. So it's plus 1. So it plots all the negative values. So this is just one hint. So here are the first more critical functions, like absolute value. In the version 2, there might be some not so nice artifacts when you drag this canvas, but this doesn't exist in the new plotting algorithm anymore. Of course, we have tangents goes to infinity, and now the more critical function graphs do come, like logarithm. Logarithm is hard to plot in my eyes, so you cannot, if you don't know what function, if you treat this as a black box, it's hard to prove or to compute numerically that logarithm goes to minus infinity here. But with interval arithmetics, it's no problem at all. Then we have infinity here, minus infinity. The downside is at the moment, what's going on? At the moment, this interval arithmetic is only used if the input is a Jesse code formula, namely that means a string. So if you do the same with a JavaScript function, That is, we have to supply something like math.log. Then it will not work anymore. Interval arithmetics cannot be applied. Huh? What happens? Well,
You use the standard plot version.
Pardon me?
You use the standard plot version too.
No. The version 2 doesn't cannot do it. Here's 4. So this is 2, and here is 4. This was a happy, a lucky incident, because we exactly tested the value 0, and math log of 0 returns minus infinity in JavaScript. But if you are slightly off, then it doesn't work anymore. But in my mouse doesn't work anymore. But with the Jesse code version, it's no problem at all. So you can drag around, it's always minus infinity. And to see the power of the new algorithm, well, these are just standard problems like rational functions, and I don't want to go into this, but here's a much more difficult one. I go back to the old algorithm and show you this strange function. It's something like x squared plus some logarithmic term. And it looks completely harmless, but because the old algorithm misses a critical point, namely it's like this. There's a minus, it's a, well, yeah, there's this problem, and it's indeed, it's here, it's minus infinity. And another one is this one. Again, version 2. It's okay. It's okay, this critical point at 1. But if you increase or decrease the distance of these two branches like this, then this critical point is completely missed in version 2, but in version 4, you see it, it's still here. Okay, so why is it not the default value, the default plotting algorithm yet? I still don't like the plotting of highly periodical functions like this one. This is not good enough in my eyes. It's still, the peaks are not good enough, and it will become worse if the function is more pathological, like this sinus of something, a factor times x squared, then it looks like this. And these are numerical artifacts, that there is not a complete blue rectangle here beside the center. Okay, but there's a lot of promise in this new algorithm, and I hope it will gradually improve and be a really good plotting algorithm, which can compete with the best computer algebra systems. And but one word of warning: every plotting algorithm is doomed to fail at one point. So for every plotting algorithm, you can find a function term which is plotted incorrectly. Yes, and this is more or less what I wanted to say you about to tell you about the new features. Further topics. I already said it in the last webinar. I'm still collecting suggestions how to what a vector field should be able to do. Please just give your opinion in at GitHub. And JSX Graph is part of the European project ITEMS. And in ITEMS, we will hold a MOOC, a massive online course on JSX Graph programming for beginners sometime in April 2021. The details are not clear yet or not published yet, but stay tuned. Maybe it's something for your colleagues or for your students or your friends to start JSX Graph programming. Okay. Then the next webinar will be on Wednesday, February 24th at 4 p.m. And I hope I will see you again. Are there some questions? Okay, if not, then have a nice day, and I hope I will see you again in February. Bye-bye.